know, Coach, you guys packed the gyms this year in a way that no team that I remember in my lifetime has packed gyms to see high school level basketball. And I one thing I observed today when I got here and I walked in with my group of people from Houston Media Watch is there's one individual that kind of stood out in the crowd at all of your games this year. Little bitty short Jewish guy with a lot of money that never spends any of it. Talk about what it means to you as a coach to draw that type of interest from a diverse group of individuals around the city, because we talked a lot about the negative coverage of the team, but clearly with the numbers of people that showed up for these games, you guys got a lot of love. Give you an opportunity as we close out to give your thoughts on the positive support that you receive for the kids.
Well, I like to hit it both ways. When you look at the negative part, even the stations that I felt like were coding us in the exact wrong way, I feel like if you're in the media, you should at least be in the middle. In terms of if you find out you're wrong on something, like I tell our kids every day, if you find out you're wrong on something, then it's not a bad thing to admit that it ain't going on. And I talked to Council with 16. I felt like they did a terrible job of being honest about what we were doing. I talked to them myself, and when I corrected some of the things, instead of saying, "Oh, okay," they just go to another question. So. In my mind, that's just a way of saying I'm just not going to admit that I'm wrong, or I'm not going to give them credit for what they did. So from that standpoint, I thought that was very wrong on them to act that way. Even when somebody says you're not covering the best team in the country, I think they're wrong too. Okay, well, we're number one now, so it didn't change after that. So somebody called and said, KCOH had 100,000 hits, but you say nobody was interested in high school basketball. Well, I think I got to check and make sure. In other words, it's implying that person that called didn't know what he was talking about, which in actuality he did.
Of course he did. Right.
So from that standpoint, I just think that was very wrong for them to do that, especially in the city that you should be trying to make what the people are doing in that city better, so it looks better around the country. So. But on the positive side, it was just unbelievable to see the people in the stands that they were rooting for us, and the community and different people that came out and supported us, and how many people were trying to get in the game. And some of those games, it was just amazing to me how many people were outside,
right,
still trying to get in.
Getting turned away at the door.
Turned away, yeah. So I even had trouble getting to the regional finals myself because of as many cars that were still trying to get into the building. So to see the support like that and to know the kids that they're supporting and how hard it's been for some of those kids growing up. And so to see that support with them was amazing.
No doubt about it. Hey, we want to say thanks, Coach. Appreciate the time. It's a very, very busy day for you, and to take the time out and to have us all over here. We really appreciate that. Hey, I'm going to tell you like I always tell you, keep your eyes on that acronym, HMW. That's Houston Media Watch. We are your media watch group. We will continue to raise hell around this town until they get it right. And I tell you, like I always tell you when I'm signing off, keep it G'd up. Dust them haters off. That's the JY. All right. Catch you next time.